Hey everybody, this is William from the Godzilla Files coming at you today with a new review. And today we're going to be looking at the Miracle House Maser Cannon model. This is by far one of my favorite figures that I've gotten since I've been starting to collect Godzilla stuff. Overall, truly detailed and amazing. But before we kind of jump right into the model itself, I just kind of want to take a quick look at the box. And here we go. So the box itself is almost like an X Plus box. Has the photo of the model on it. And on each side has a little bit more information, as you can see here. I got this on Amazon for about $110 shipping. And I've been waiting to kind of pull the trigger on this for quite some time, and once it went down in price, I jumped on it as quickly as possible. This is based off the Maser Cannon from War of the Gargantuas, and this does make an appearance in a couple of Godzilla films, even though it is from stock footage. So this is the box. Like I said, nothing crazy, but I just wanted to show it to you. So let's jump right in and take a look at this model. All right, everybody, and here is the model itself. Right off the bat, let me just say this. The Maser Cannon is probably my favorite super weapon from the Showa period. I think it represents the Showa period perfectly. It has that mix of high-end sci-fi with some realistic capabilities. This is definitely the quintessential super weapon from that period of time, and it's probably why it's my favorite. Now, this is based off of the War of the Gargantuas look, which would find itself in other Godzilla films thanks to stock footage. So let's go right into this. First off, the detail on this is pretty stunning. You know, all over the side here, as you can tell, there's some Japanese written there. All the pipes are very well colored. You know, it really does look like they took some real care for this. And just like an X Plus figure, it does feel like it did come out of the film itself. As with anything, this is a little, there are some things that you should be aware of. One, there are some areas where it's very thin plastic, so things can easily snap off. So while this can be a toy for some people, it should be known that this should still be handled with some care. And a perfect example of this is the mirrors here, and also there's little pipes that come up that you should be careful with. Now, the detail isn't just on the Maser Cannon. There is some detail here in the car. Just like in the film, it is just pretty much just a big truck, and there's some little detail on the top here. So like always, I'll have photos at the end so you can take a quick look and get a better idea of the detail that is on this model. One of the best things about this model is that it actually came put together, and that works out great for me because honestly, I don't know if any of you have seen the model kit for this, but it looks crazy complicated. I saw it on eBay, and you know, while I really wanted a Maser Cannon in my collection, I just knew I wasn't going to go with that because I wouldn't be able to put it together. And honestly, this was my biggest fear when I bought this off Amazon. You know, when I bought it, I was just really worried that I just overpaid for the model kit itself. And my girlfriend didn't help matters when she kind of tried to trick me into thinking that I did buy the model kit. But luckily, everything came out great. I do think this is a great looking piece. And there are some other things here. First off, it is on wheels, so you can actually move these if you would like. So that's pretty great. They're connected to a little latch here. So, you know, once they're connected, they'll kind of follow each other. The other thing that is connected is a little battery pack. So there's a battery in this car here that helps light up this model. So let me turn it on for you guys so you can take a better look here. Here you go. So just like in the film itself, the neck piece here lights up and it's actually pulsating. Now, I'm not sure if you can see it very well in this video, but hopefully in the photos that I take, it will actually come out a little better. So you can see here, like again, pulsating. It actually goes all the way up to the top here. So this piece here lights up as well. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't shoot any blue lightning out, but, you know, can't fault it for that, I guess. And I love this. I think this looks great. I think pulsating neck looks pretty amazing. You know, I think it just adds another piece of detail to this model, which I think just goes above and beyond what I was kind of hoping for. Now, the other reason why I got this is because I kind of wanted something that might scale with my X Plus figures. I do have a lot of X Plus 30 centimeter figures, so I was always kind of looking and hoping that this would match. And I brought one up. Let me grab him. Now, so here he is, and I'm going to kind of put everything together and try to see if we can kind of see how well these scale together. So Gigan actually went up against these, whether it be in stock footage or not. He did go up against the Maser Cannons, and they did do some good damage to him. But, you know, overall, I think this looks in scale. You know, the problem is that the Maser Cannons were always on a hilltop somewhere, far from the actual kaiju, so we don't get to see too much size comparison. But I would say I'm pretty happy with this. I think this works out pretty well overall. Okay, I'm going to shut this off real quick. And there you go. So it's a quick and easy switch. Basically, when you're done with this, all you want to do is you actually want to move the neck like this and put it down. So, and now it is good to go. It actually has a little base there that I can lay on. You know, again, like I said, overall, just an amazing model. I strongly recommend it for anyone that's looking to add a Mazer Cannon into their collection. So before I go, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody that has subscribed. Last week, we passed 300, which totally blew me away. And I just thought it would be nice to say thank you to everybody. I never thought I would get this many subs. I also need to give out a special shout out to my girlfriend, Veronica, who got me started in this and kind of pushed me to make this channel. And she's really the reason why I make these videos. So, you know, thank you to her. Also, relating to Veronica, we are going to be doing a new series where we watch Godzilla films and then kind of talk about them afterwards. You know, I thought this would be kind of fun. She hasn't seen too many, maybe just a small handful. And this was kind of a way for me to enjoy these films again with someone that might not have gone and looked at them any other way. So I'm kind of excited for you guys to see that. So you should expect that in the coming weeks. Also, right now I'm in a video of hers where I try to do her makeup. Pretty funny stuff there. So I would recommend taking a look at her channel, The Next Level. And as always, guys, you know, once again, thank you for everything. I hope you've enjoyed this video and I will see you all later.